hello and welcome to A Flare for the 70s, UK Gold's Friday night tribute to the decade that brought us Charlie's Angels, platform shoes, flares, of course. And you remember Space Dust? It was a bit like sherbet and it made your tongue feel as though it was about to explode. And I didn't know this, but apparently that was eventually banned.
Anyway, tonight we're transporting you back in time and space with some great programmes lined up. Plus we'll be doing a fair bit of grooving with music from the decade, and we'll take a look at some of the main news events too.
And as usual, we have a special guest who featured prominently on 70s TV. We'll be finding out about what they were up to then and what they're doing now.
So, UK Gold shows its flair for the 70s with some high street comedy next in Are You Being Served?
Then we whisk you off in a Ford Granada, brown, of course, for the pilot to the sweetie, that's Regan, at 10 past 10.
It's a slice of life according to Shelley with Howell Bennett at 10 to 12.
And that'll be followed by a double bill of drama with Hazel and Ben Survivors. So, that's the lineup for this week's A Flair for the 70s.
News events from the decade provided filmmakers with stacks of brand new material, such as the Apollo 13 aborted moonwalk mission, Frank Serpico's revelations about New York police corruption, there was the Watergate affair, Vietnam, and the 69-day ordeal of the survivors of an air crash in the Andes.
Now, tonight's special guest was involved in none of those, thankfully, but she was a regular face on the box. She got to make lots of small films, travel all over the world, and would send your dads down to the potting shed. No more clues for now, all will be revealed in just over half an hour.
Now, though, we're going back in time to do a spot of my favourite thing, shopping at the timeless Grace Brothers department store. Although with hardly any customers, it's amazing it survived. Are You Being Served? Welcome back. We've 2 hours of drama still to come tonight on UK Gold with Hazel and Survivors.
Okay, so let's go on now and have a look at what's coming up next week.
Hello out there. This is a new departure into the world of hipsters, beatniks and the criminal fringe.
Carry on the good work. Must go now. Bye-bye.
So, sit back. Relax. You're in the safe hands of Minder.
One of the best.
The female of the species puts pressure on young Rosie.
No more blowing kisses. That's got to be understood. You don't realise that after every one from you, I get six from passing lorry driver.
At 11:20...
Suspect is armed with a revolver and has fired a shot.
Softly, softly, task force.
Come on, you're joking.
No.
A cool contest follows with serious contenders. Hounslow, Kingston-upon-Thames and Lambeth.
Give us the instruction because people are fascinated as to what goes on in Knockout.
Terry Nation's survivors are under fire.
Come on!
I told her Huxley's ultimatum. She went of her own accord.
Get hip, groovy chicks, with a flair for the 70s, next Friday on UK Gold.
From the future to very much the past now, as we delve into the archives and rediscover some of the main news stories two decades ago.
You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. You can get it if you really want. Try and try. You succeed at last. Yeah. Persecution, you must fear. Win or lose, you gotta get your sheep. You got your mind set on a dream. Succeed at last.
24 years ago that was out, and it doesn't seem a day over 132 years. Also happening in 73 was the wedding of Princess Anne to Captain Mark Phillips. It's also the year that footballers Ryan Giggs and Jamie Redknapp were born.
And don't forget, Crossroads was knocking spots off Coronation Street.
Now it's time to welcome this week's guest. She was a presenter on the world's longest-running children's programme, during which she got to do some amazing things with sticky back plastic. The show, at its peak, had 8 million viewers, but as a broadcaster, she's proved there is life after Blue Peter. She is Valerie Singleton. Welcome along.
Hello.
Thanks, nice
Hello,
to have you.
Thank you.
Now, if you don't mind, we'll start with Blue Peter.
Okay.
And, of course, you were with it for, I think it was 10 years, was it? And you must have loved it.
It was actually 9 years. It was 62 to 71. So, really, when the 70s came, I kind of was just about to leave Blue Peter.
And you were doing the special assignment.
I was doing the special assignment. So I went back into the studio every now and again. But I felt I kind of grew up in the 70s because I went and did grown-up telly.
Mm.
I joined Nationwide, so it was...
What actually was the highlight of Blue Peter for you in your time?
For me, the travelling, I think. Mm. All the travels in the summer and some of the people that I met too. Mm. Not studios, because I'm not really a studio person. I don't like being in studios. I like being out and about and seeing new places and meeting new people. Mm. It's always the best bit, I think.
So how did your career progress in the 70s?
It was very busy at the beginning of the 70s. I was actually on almost every night, got a bit worried people would get fed up because I was doing Blue Peter special assignments, going back into Blue Peter to kind of trail those. I joined Nationwide doing Consumer Unit. I was doing Val Meets the VIPs.
Wow.
So it was, you know, till about 75, really very busy. And then I joined Nationwide more full-time and became a main presenter on that programme. Mm. So it was great fun.
We all, of course, remember Lulu. The elephant
yes.
in Blue Peter.
Who
Did you find there was
Lulu?
Much other stuff that went wrong?
Nothing that stands out quite as much as that, but there were, you know, animals particularly never did. I mean, they always fell asleep at the wrong moment and or got away, or snakes slithered under the sofa, or, you know, I was bitten by a mouse once, I remember, which was excruciating and had to go off to hospital afterwards with sort of dripping blood. And they thought it was hilarious when I said I'd been bitten by a mouse, so... But mainly things like that, yes. I think perhaps the worst thing that ever happened to me was when all the film went down. And instead of getting the music and the opening sequence, and it was one of the few programmes that I was doing on my own, because in the very early days it still allowed you to take a holiday, and Chris Trace was on holiday. And I remember thinking, what's happened to the music? And the whole programme had to be kind of rearranged on air. So, and there was no autocue in those days, so I was literally... reading these sort of scribbled messages on a big cardboard that the floor manager was... So I was kind of talking to camera and trying to read these at the same time.
Oh,
so there was a nice feeling when you got to the end of it. And
a big...
You actually managed to get through it without having made a complete mess of it. And so that was probably the most scary thing, I think.
I was just wondering, could you make me a Porsche out of some of these or not?
Listen, if
Sorry,
I make a Porsche, I think I'm going to keep it for myself. Do you mind? I'm not going to give it away.
Do you get fed up of people doing things like that? You know, the sticky back plastic and all that?
Well, I read the other day in a piece that Pete Purvis had in the Mail that he was thoroughly fed up with people coming up and making cracks about sticky back plastic. You have heard them before, but, you know, for people who make them, you know, you can't really put them down. You have to sort of laugh as if it's the first time you've ever heard it.
Yeah.
I tend to do a lot of conferences and things like that now, and kind of, you know, professors or businessmen stand up and say, you know, I've got my notes that I prepared earlier, as they pull them forward. So you can't groan, you have to laugh.
Do you actually keep in touch with any of the other presenters for Blue Peter?
Well, John's living in Mallorca, so I don't see very much of him. Pete lives up in the north, but, you know, if they walked in here now, we'd be friends like we were in those days, or I could... If I found myself near Pete, ring up and say, can I have a bed for the night? So we're still mates, yes.
Mm. Now, you know there's continuity announcing. Well, that's actually what Glenn and I do. Do you think you could give me any tips?
Do you need them?
Well, a few would be handy from a
All right, you don't have a clock. We used to have a clock in those days. That was one of the biggest tips. If you like, I can tell you all about how to look at a camera and read the clock at the same time.
We'll go and have a chat later on. Is that okay?
Yeah, we'll
brilliant.
Give you a few tips.
Thanks very much, Val. Brilliant.
Let's... take a look at one of the most hard-hitting cop shows to hit this country. It's the pilot film to the Sweeney called Regan. Can I have a word, Duval?